Welcome back to another video. Now, in this current video, we are going to be addressing the EMSAT Physics and EMSAT Mathematics examination, in which we are going to be selecting every single video as part of a series of videos, a question straight from the EMSAT Math and EMSAT Physics examination. This will help you as part of your EMSAT practice, revision, preparation for your EMSAT examination, whether physics or mathematics. In addition, take a look at the video description where we have very important and useful links for videos which are for our members of the channel, in addition to links to courses and workshops straight on our academy, which have been highly reviewed. Students are enrolling in the courses and they are seeing results. Now, without further ado, make sure that you subscribe and click the notification bell in order to stay tuned with all of these releases for every single upcoming question. Now, let's get right to the problem. Question straight from the geometry part of the EMSAT mathematics. Let's get right to the question and try to figure out what is the correct answer and which ones are wrong and why. Now, the question says, how are these figures related? We do have an object over here and we do have the following image for such an object. And we need to identify what are the movements which caused such an object to be mapped to such an image. Now let's take a look at the options that we have. Reflection. Now reflection simply means if I take a point from this object, I'm going to flip it up to this, from this point to this point, and this point I'm going to be flipping it also to this point, such that I'm going to be maintaining to a certain point the distance from the axis I'm flipping it from. So in this current case, the axis I'm reflecting at is the y-axis. So obviously, if we do have a reflection along the y-axis, this object is going to be mapped to this following image. So in this current case, we find out that reflection is not the case. How about translation? When we say translation, it means movement sideways or up and down, but with maintaining the exact same shape. So in this current case, if I would say I'm going to be moving upwards, the shape would look like this. It will be exactly the same without any change to its orientation. Just simply you take it from this position all the way upwards. This is an example of a vertical translation in this case. However, if we take a look at dilation, for example, this is also wrong because dilation seems or means that we are going either to be zooming out or zooming in. The object is going to be bigger or smaller depending on the operation. And if I'm going to say not related, this is a tricky part, which is wrong because there is a relationship between these objects, which is rotation. Even though it might sound tricky, but rotation is the correct choice, and here's why. Now, this requires a bit of imagination. Take a look at this line. Imagine if I rotate it over here, it will fit right here. How about this line? If I rotate it over here, it's going to be fitting right over there. Now, in this current case, we do have a 180 degrees rotation, which is about this axis, the x-axis, where you take a point and you flip it all the way to the other side. If you apply it to this line, you're going to be flipping it all the way over here to this current line as well. So if you take a look at this current shape, you just simply rotated the entire shape this way. Now, it requires, like I've mentioned, a bit of imagination for you to be able to figure this out. Try to imagine moving this side all the way over here and rotating this side all the way over here and rotating this side over here and this one as well over here, and you would realize that this shape is being rotated to match this following shape. So the answer which best fits the current problem is rotation. Now, I truly hope that you found this current question helpful and beneficial. Now, stay tuned for the upcoming releases in which we are going to have a series, numerous questions that are surely going to support you in terms of the preparation for the EMSAT physics and mathematics. Don't forget to take a look at the video description for all of these links related to important courses, workshops, tools, membership videos, some videos we are going to be releasing addressing key important questions from the EMSAT examination are going to be dedicated for the channel members. So if you're interested in that as well, take a look at the video description for all of these details. In the meanwhile, don't forget to subscribe, click and smash that like button, and I'll see you in the upcoming video.